Okay, let's run our quick sound test. See what's working and what's not. Okay, so hopefully you have music in stream, yes? Because I can't hear it over the music that's going through my monitor.
Seconds.
Okay, so we'll just wait for the ads that I haven't asked to be on to run. I'm getting annoyed at that. I have ads turned off, and you are being accosted by ads.
Yeah.
So you can hear me. Can you hear music?
Yes, but it's quiet.
The music is quiet. Take it to 60% in transition. Let's see if that works. Oh! That wasn't supposed to happen. Okay, so because I've got the overhead camera in the way of my screen, I can't see my transitions. So, I apologize for that. I'm hoping that.
Yes, it quite clearly.
The question is, can you hear me over it? Because
Yes, I
my
can hear you.
mic is a good distance away, although I've turned it up, I don't know how reliable it is. So, we're going to be aiming to finish off the lion. And then I will move on to a Moritat. My spare sword. Now I apologise, I forgot to charge this last night, so there's a bit more light on me than usual. In fact, it's rare for me to even be back on the camera these days, as I've not been very well. And I don't like people over worrying, but this time it's not being very well of a different kind, aside from the usual hay fever and allergy problems that I'm getting. No, give me that. I need to clean my magnifying glass. I've been suffering a bit with my mental health, I'm afraid. February tends to be quite a bad time of year for me because it's when all the tragedy seems to strike, as well as my own aging up day. Speaking of my aging up day, I will be away this Sunday, so I will not be streaming Sunday. But everything else is as normal. I will be streaming on Friday and Saturday and the following Wednesday. And as always with my streams, until we're doing Gosh in March, our streams are in aid of Elm Wildlife Trust, so if you can donate to those, please do. The links are in the About tabs below, and if you're post-watching on YouTube, it will be in the description below. So if you can donate to them, please do. If not, please share the link, get it round, see if we can get other people donating to them. Sorry, I'm used to seeing my camera in the middle of my screen. You're over there to my left today, because otherwise all you would have is the bar cam and the microphone instead of this. Good grief. This is a very stubborn. That's better. That one. I've lost my actual polishing cloth. Always. Yeah, grabbing them with my fingers. They got great big thumbprints and things across them. Hard to see the detail for thumbprints. So yeah, I forgot to charge this. The light doesn't have much light, so you may see me using the headlamp from time to time. Let's get because I'm trying to see what I'm doing. And I warn you, the headlamp is pretty bright, so without pointing it directly too much at you. That's just one lamp. That's the two little lamps. That's it super bright, and then it does that. Sorry for the strobing. I don't know why people put strobing on those lights. But we'll see how this goes. But yeah, I may end up having to use the headlamp. So I've just got a couple of things to fix. We've got, hopefully we'll move on to the Moritat today. But we will see. Nothing ever goes as planned on a Wednesday after all. I do plan to be upping my streams painting at some point. I don't know when yet, but at some point. It's just a matter of reworking real life around everything at the moment. Come here, I want some dead grass. So I've got a set area I'm trying to work in because I've put the camera at a very specific point, which means I've got this tiny little window to move in. I know they're self-adhesive, but great, I've got a sea urchin on my finger now. Don't do this at home, kids. Without an adult, anyway. Come on. We want a tuft of dead alien grass. Right there. Give me my glue. Thank you. I'm going to have to get this thing off my finger. Off. Thank you. Just to add a little spice and flavour to the bases, really. Where else could we put one? Where does Marini stand? He stands there, so I probably couldn't. Oh, I might be able to. Yep, okay. That is a lump of green stuff. Oh, that's way too much glue. Right, an air bubble. That's not supposed to happen. If the glue wants to go there, I suppose you can put a nice big dollop of, just spread it all over this, and then Marini can go up here, can't he? Luckily I keep a bin behind me. Another tuft of sea urchinness. Call them sea urchins because that's what these little tufts of grass remind me of. But actually, Deadlands tuft from Army Painter. But they still remind me of little sea urchins. Okay, so we've got two for the price of one. Okay. No, it doesn't want to get them off. Off! Thank you. Hold you by your tufts. So you can get in there and just add a little bit of accent to our diorama base. And then we'll get a little tuft of green to go next to it. I've somehow flattened a load of them. How did that happen? We've lost 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well, I'm sure I can do something with them. It's not a total loss. Come on, sticky in. completely done with the bass yet, but I would like to add the accents in while I can. You lot can go back in there, we don't want to lose any more. Yep, there you go. Army painters, tufts. They are pretty good for quite a few little jobs, to be honest. Not just army painting, but your D&D models and so on. There's tufts off my fingers now. All right. So I need to finish up washing the red. Okay. Red, but this deeper crimson one looks better for it. Who told you you could jump out at me, controller? We're not using you for anything today. Go over there and charge quietly away from me. Yeah, we know how it is here, folks. Tech Wednesday. So we've got to somehow get his arms on next. That's going to be fun. So we'll put all of this stuff over here. So we will be gluing him in a bit. Get his arms in place and so on. Put them all over there. Including Marini. Oh, I have a wash brush here. Don't need to use the new one yet. On the red, I can start doing the dark blue wash. Oh, okay, so we will be working with metallics. Every day, I hope. I hope. Only to get shot down by the model itself. Wings. It's everybody. I just want to do a little dab. A little dabs in here to gory up the gory detail. Excuse me, here we go again. Sorry, it's tree pollen season, folks, so I'm sneezing a fair bit lately. Are we going to sneeze? You watch, it's going to happen while I'm in the middle of something now. Because that's just how things roll. Darkstone Nightshade, that's probably a good bluey black colour. Have a sip of tea to prove I am taking care of myself. I'm just going to do a quick check on my streams to make sure the titles are correct, because lately it's been saying things it shouldn't be. So, hop over to pick where I should be streaming. Is that?
That's what it says.
So it should be saying minis, not mins.
It's missing nine.
So apparently I've typoed and we've got mins instead of minis. Okay, so I'm just going to go through and fix those. No, I mean what we've had. Sundat, Saturdat, Night, N-I-T-E. Bite Night instead of Fright Night. Yeah, we've had a few typos. I mean, it wouldn't be our stream here without typos, would it? So I'm just going to nip the video producer over on Twitch, because if it's saying mins on Kick, it's saying it on Twitch. So, stream manager. Thank you, Twitch, for this awesome stream manager. It is so in-depth and pretty useful. I want to give credit where it's due. I don't always want to be hooping on you. So there we go. That should now be working. I'm going to go out into the channel so that I can actually watch it, because for some reason in the admin view it locks up. There we go. Right, so back to watching OBS and having chat in the wrong place, so just so I can see the chat. There we go. I have to move the chat again for Saturday, for Friday and Saturday. And so to reiterate, people, I will not be around on Sunday. Just want people to make sure that I won't. I don't want you coming in on Sunday thinking it's going to be. However, Hilo may be streaming over on YouTube. I can't really advertise him because he is impossible to get into a routine. If you're hearing this, Hilo. I keep telling him he needs to get into a routine so you guys know when to log on. But he won't have any of it. And now we've got blue on the skull. How typical. Luckily, we're doing the final wash phases down. Just to darken them up a bit. And then we will be doing the final details and they are done. And I will do the repair work where the wash is getting where it's not supposed to. These guys are supposed to be part of the Heretic Legions, hence their darker coloured armour tone to what you would consider as Ultramarines. Hoping to have them finished today. This is really not too much to go. Just a few wash downs, a bit of highlighting. Assembling, and then they will be ready for varnishing, which will happen outside and off stream and off camera, because it's really quite difficult to get the logistics of that in the spray box. They also have to wait for this horrible weather to break as well. I believe there is a cat that would like out. Flap up so she can do what she wants, you know, to stand around there and turn into a skeleton. She's got food though, surely.
She's
And, oh, she's actually et it. My goodness, my trick's working. My feet get cold for the comfort of a cat. Stop the colouring out. Turn them more into their midnight colouring. Oops, sounds like she actually wants food. See, I've had to move to a rather drastic measure with the cat. She was getting fussy with her food and refusing to eat. So what I did was take away normal food, put down biscuits so she had them as an option so she wouldn't starve, and just refused to feed her cat meat for a couple of days. Now suddenly she wants her cat meat. Much darker blue.
They're known for their subterfuge, how dark their colours are, but that also it makes kind of sense why their colours are so dark.
Just getting really, really, really dark, and then we can start to highlight the last bits and then fully assemble and they're done. Now what? We'll just leave the cat flap open.
She's after flakes.
She's not. No, don't. Not give her fish flakes. We're trying to break that addiction.
That's why I'm not doing it. I'm gonna open the cat flap.
Just leave it open. Leave it as an option.
It's getting beyond a joke now, cat.
Like if she doesn't want the food that's offered here, she can go to other home. And get the food offered there. I'm sure she's spoiling it with something like gourmet. So the cat is one of those community cats where the community cares for local ferals and strays. If we see them in a bad way, we step in. Don't stop them from doing cat things, obviously, so they continue running around. So if they do actually have a home nearby, they have a good chance of going back, or at least us locating the human that they may have originally belonged to and getting them reunited. Okay, so these two, though, they have about five or six homes in the village. I'm just one of them. Today because I've been sheltering them from the storm for the last 12 hours. The storm's just broke, so they can go off and do cat things again now. Just to make sure a tree or something doesn't get blown onto them. Falls over. Great. Here, go stand on the blue tack. Flex. That over there as well. Now let's have a look at your armios. Actually, before we deal with his armios, let's deal with his sidearms. Them and them. So what we got? We have got his grenades. Dagger. Grenades, I'm going to need no oil. It occurs to me that it might be better if I just use the headset, seeing as I keep moving all over the room. And I can put that close to my mouth and you can hear me. So I'm looking for non-oil. And a dark green. Where's my dark angels? There it is. Right, now then, let's have a look through our paints. We have got the wet palette on standby if I do need it. Actually, double check his sidearm. Black and gold, okay. Gold. Abaddon black. What else have we got? Need the bolt gun silver. Is that a grey or a silver? I've got my silver. This is a grey, a very thick grey, so it's needing some paint thinner. Okay. Right. The snippies. Snippy snip snips. Come here, get in my hand. I'm having a bit of trouble gripping today because with it being so cold and nasty, and I'm not just talking about this very incident, but over the past few hours, my tendons are playing up quite badly. Right, I'm actually going to have to do something a little dangerous. Do not do this without proper adult supervision, people, young children's. And I say this in the case as well, in some adults, don't do this without proper call for backup if something goes wrong. Now I do have very trained hands for this, but that doesn't stop accidents, so a constant reminder of use sharp objects responsibly. Now I've got two sidearms and a guidance and plasticine here. We don't need the paint handle right now, so that can come out and go to one side. Oh, out. Don't need the cloaks with me either. At all. Come on, go away. We'll be repainting you lot. Found so many faults in them, it's silly. Alright, so I'm actually gonna I am gonna need my wet palette. Okay. So we'll put these over here for a minute. I say that because I actually have some primer on wet palette. And to prove that it's primer, if I can, there you go, surface primer. So priming paint, usually used in airbrushes, but I'm not using my airbrush yet. And as always, I paint more myself than anything else. need more than two drops. That's dry. Get everywhere the primer initially didn't get, as well as patch up everywhere that needs new primer. There we go. So I'll let that one dry. Put the wet palette out of the way again. Now I actually need a brown wash, so where's my Seraphim Sepia? That one can go dry over there. Oi! No slacking. Don't make me stick you to a base. Actually, that might not be a bad idea. Give. I don't need a lot. And it sticks to everything but where I want it to. That's just typical. Stay. Right. Seraphim Sepia over there now, just in case I need it again. I don't need that one because he's not using that sword. That's to the spare sword over there. Wonder, can we get that on him now? Make sure he's secure enough to get onto these things, of course. So it sits down there, does it? It's going to be fun. So we're going to try and get that down between his backpack and his cloak. Right. Snips. I might have to take off some of that halo's. So initially I thought it stood like that, but apparently not. To go right down into his cloak, so I need to take a bit more off. Let's clean those bits up. It's just one little bit of hair stopping it from going into place. That drips everywhere. That's the only problem with the Citadel glue. Yeah, have some super glue. Oh, but it's like water. It takes a while to dry as well. But hopefully if it dries, it should be strong enough to hold him in place. And then that belt buckle, where does that go? Up there. See, that's going to be just drop it. Yay. Luckily its glue didn't go anywhere. This is possibly one of the more tricky bits to glue on. There we go. Worry about the hair later, I don't want to dislodge it. So I'll just prop him there. Now where do we put his grenades and thingies? Where's his grenades for the base? So 26, 20, and 25. So, frag grenade and stasis grenades. Where would they go on him then? Okay, that's going to be fun. Right. While the glue dries, where's my wash brush? Non-oil. Let that dry. Yep. Put the gun over there so we don't lose it. chocolate or uniform black. And scabbards of this size are relatively easy to paint, to be honest, for the most part, except when you get teeny tiny fine details like I've got here with the wing. So I'm only painting the bits black that are black, just to give them that uniform black colour. Especially where I've just used a grey primer. And then I will go over the metallics with a silver. I think it was silver, wasn't it? At least it's dry. Gold. We'll be going over with gold. Also gives me a uniform tone to paint up to if I overpaint the gold. Oh. Sorry, headset's putting pressure on my forehead where it shouldn't. By headset, I mean this thing, the magnifying glass. Sorry for the horrible swallowing sounds. Like I said, it's been easier. I'm not hitting the microphone now because we're using this one instead. And it follows me around the room, so it's easier for you to hear me. Ye old Ronnie here. Dog that died back in 2016. His hair is all over my paint set. His hair got absolutely everywhere, bless. It's happened on blank. I want the normal oil again. I need a smaller brush with a thinner tip. Yep, my 3-0. Oh. Don't let the organisation of so far fool you today, folks. It's an illusion. Hair was a point of interest earlier. Oh, good grief. Christmas music? Really? It's taken me a month and a half to get Christmas songs out of my head. And then, for the last few weeks, I've had Mr. Toot stuck in my head. Now we're back to Christmas songs. I feel like I've gone full circle in less than a year. I wasn't at such a time-critical phase. I might have changed the music. Okay, let's see how this is going to be. Right, first of all, skip. Let's find the Christmas music. Uplifting, upbeat food. Where are we at now? Epic inspiration. So we're back at the start. So we're near the end then. Remove from queue. Remove from queue. Remove from queue. There. No more Christmas music for today. Doing the areas where I know it's metallic colouring to add some nice stark contrast to pull up the details. feel like he's not very sturdy on his face for some reason. Excess off. Alright. Last touches on that bit for him now. Let him go over there and dry while we deal with his sidearms. This halo doesn't keep moving. Might have to secure that in place with some green stuff at this rate. Over there for now as well. Where's that thin brush I had a minute ago? Not that one. Put them over there for the minute. That's better. Right. Oh, and the wind's back. If we're getting laggy again, I apologise, folks. Sure, this side of the sword is dagger is finished. I'm just on the grounds that then I can move it and then paint the other side. Me the Roman legions, actually, this one. Now I'm getting covered in Norn oil. Great. Guess my compression gloves are going to be going in for a wash as well. I may do, just leave it. I can grab it then when I need it. Let's roll that back so I can get at my fingers. The problem is lower down my finger anyway. I don't want it sticking to me. Right, so while that wash dries, that arm can go in there so we don't lose it. Let's go back to the base. And the metallics. Right, mouse, budge up. You're in the ways. Right. Talking computer mouse, not mouse mouse. What have you done there? I'm covered in Nuln oil. I forgot to close the lid properly as I shook the pot. Get off, cat hair. Right, thank you. Oh, yeah. I mean, it's Wednesday for a start. Away her. I'm sure I saw a number on this guy. Apparently I didn't. Okay. Fine. There is copper rust, but that particular one was gold. No, stay on your blue tack, bad little marine. Yeah, the copper rust colour is probably more black on camera than it is. It's the old Citadel paint colour. If I get it right, there you go. Tin Bits it was called. I don't know what it's called these days.
Warblock bronze.
Is that a near black?
Yeah, it's the... what is that Tin Bits is called now?
Okay, so apparently it's called Warplock Bronze now. And I've just painted myself green. We are having a paint myself day, I think. No, this is not white tack, it's blue tack. Scorpion green, that horrible colour. Now stay still and let me do your eyes. A horrible garish day glow green. Perfect for some jobs though, like eyes in a power armor visor. Another cat hair trying to get involved here. Go away, you're not a paintbrush. Yes, that is two paint pots you're hearing, just to show you, right there, bubbly one and a not so bubbly one next to it. Yeah, it might be, the day glow ones are, but I think it's got a different name now. I'm actually using a lot of the old Citadel paints today. And they changed the name back in 2012. Shows you how long I've had these paints going. If I remember rightly, don't power armor eyes go off when the person in it's dead?
Yes.
Yeah, that's all right then.
Yeah.
Only asking before I glue someone to his base and then I can't get to someone else's eyes.
Okay. Look at the carnage the mind's caused there.
Covered me in paint. There's painted my desk. This is going to have a wash. I'm still leaving him alone because we're waiting for the glue to dry. the glue to dry. Now, where did I put my Citadel glue? There. Ah. Hopefully, this time, he sticks. Put green stuff there to give him a half-decent surface to stick to. Stay. No, stay. Stay. Doesn't want to stay now. Am I going to have to get the pincers on you, mister? They're numbered. Although I have actually swapped a couple of the heads down. So that head was supposed to be there and that head's supposed to be there. But I thought they looked better the other way around. But yeah, you asked how do you know which bits go where. Let me just gently move this one. So that he's out of the way and his glue can dry. Right. You have IKEA instructions. I'm assuming you can see that with me just putting it out of the light. Hey. If you're back into meow, I will chase you away and you can go bug someone else. I know you've got about 8 homes. Are you trolling the cat with toffees? You're trolling the cat with toffee wrappers. See me? Everybody is taken to trolling the troll. Okay. All right, so I'm going to try and get on with some more. This handle, so we're going to swap it around and paint the top now. Ooh, oof, okay. Snips. Sorry that I'm now blowing down the microphone. It is practically next to my mouth. I opted for the headset instead of the normal streaming microphone because I'm constantly back and forth across the room, so I'm constantly getting distant and quiet and you can't hear me, where this thing just follows me across, so it's easier for everyone. Dusted off the file a little bit. This file could use a bit of a cleanse, I think. That's much better. Prime up to fix where we've just sanded it and where primer didn't get down the handle. And yes, that is air gun primer for my. Usually use, which is my airbrush. Comes in handy when you just need little dabs to prime a little bit of plastic. When you don't end up wearing it like I did earlier, of course. Right, so that's that one fixing. Green stuff, where is it? Ah, there it is. How long before I wear some Dark Angels green, I wonder? Is it that one? No. It has to be that one then. Yep. I've got you on the TV so I can sort out the other room ready to use. Bench sander. Never mind. Some questions are best left unanswered for me. I tend to use bench sanders outside personally. Everyone has their thing. And while they dry. Else I need to paint, but I've got to find that angel again. Ah, there he is. I need... That's a cream colour. The Gundam models. I hope you're wearing a face mask with it. I'm assuming these are the large Gundam models, not the table high ones. You know, by table high I mean probably as big as Lionel here, or Transformers high, which is about that, roughly. A few inches, basically. Oh, it's the big ones, is it? Oh, Transformers High. Honestly, the small hand engravers are good for that job. And it still has the consistency of clotted cream. Paint thinner in then. Again, don't do this without a responsible adult presence. The base plates are dinner plate size. Still hope you've got a mask, because resin isn't something to scoff at if it gets into your system. I'm going to leave that over there. Let's go find my bleached bone from the other set. Too much. I didn't want that much out. Oh well. So apparently my old Citadel one still needs some time to spend with paint thinner to bring it out of the consistency of clotted cream. Gets rid of that rogue hair. It's amazing what you can use nail clippers for. And by rogue hair, I do mean the bristles on the brush. It bent off and it was going to paint everything but what I wanted it to paint. Need a brown. This is a wash, not a brown. Tool I made using a pin and an old USB cover just to clear paint channels. God, are you kidding me? Fine, we'll use the drill. There's a sword over there, shoulder pads are there, and so is an arm piece there, his gun's there as well. And then his dagger's here waiting to be painted. Thank you. see if that worked. Yes, there we go. A little bit of red. Brush for horrible jobs, of which I have plenty right now. Neither of those. Not that one, that one, that one. Where's my two? There it is. So you can all see what I'm painting. Oh, sounds like that cat's now on zoomies. Come on. I know there's a hair that got in here. I don't want you ruining my wash in a bit. This is meant to represent leather. Take a breather for a minute. In that split second, a piece of dust attaches to the brush. That time of year now where there's dust and pollen starting to fly everywhere en masse. Oh, grief. She's doing Simon's cat level zoomies. You can hear the stampeding up there. Bring him back over because we've got leather bits to paint. Oh, I need a better brush. According to the lack of anyone else having any leather packs, I'm assuming he's particularly special in his unit. I'll have more leather packs to paint, but oh well, I'm not going to complain. I can't remember if Lionel had any on his. I don't think he does. Not seeing any leather bits. There would, so I'm going to itch like crazy. Then do it outside when it's dry. This is the long-term thing I learnt ages ago when dealing with the larger models. Do it outside when you've got good weather. Arguing with the hand arms now. So the Lionel bits need to be left to dry for a minute. We are almost done with him. It's actually a little bit more work than I expected, I have to admit. Well then, dip them in some hot water at some point. As you can see, these guys have been base sprayed. Apparently, except there. How did we miss that? I remember turning him upside down for that. Right, let's bring back the wet palette and put everything back in the box so we don't lose it. Right. No, I turned him upside down and sprayed him. It still didn't take. I assume that the wind got in the way of this. This is a primer I'm brushing on thin layers into him. Unfortunately, the weather's so bad outside, I can't take him outside for a re-spray. So it's just going to be better to carefully paint a watered-down air spray primer onto him instead. Actually one of the very few models I've pre-assembled partly. because sometimes, just sometimes, there are models that are just better part assembled. This one is one of them. Especially if you have a job where you're going to be doing a lot of green stuff repairs or stability issues, sometimes it's better to pre-assemble to get some balance and to find out where your repairs are going to be the most severe so that you can get in, do what you need to do, and then prime over it, better disguising it for you. So it all depends on the situation you're in and how you like to work. I don't want to see any plain plastic anywhere except on your feet. And by your feet, I mean the very bottoms of your feet where you get glued. Okay, horrible hairdryer noise coming.
Okay.
I'm sure I turned it on. Oh, I did turn it on. Don't worry, it's on a cold setting, folks. Just enough to help that paint dry a little bit. Whoops. Nothing fell off, that's all right. Well, nothing of import anyway. As we see where I still need to get the primer. Prime my own fingernails first. The answer is to someone that asked a question some time ago now. Can you still paintbrush prime if you don't have access to spray tins of cut prime? Yes, because you can get airbrush primer, which allows you to thin it out and make it an ideal primer. Now, if you're someone like me who's using a wet palette, you can do one drop and just let the wet palette spread it out, and it thins it out as if you were using it in an airbrush, so you don't end up losing your detail as a result. These brushes out of the way again. Because we're about to use the air dryer again. Now doing that air dryer, I did spot another spot that didn't get caught. The reason I keep drying it to see where I need to put the primer is it brings it all down to the same deep grey. So it's showing me the exposed resins and plastics a bit easier. So I can get in there with a thinner head brush and get it primed. Oh. Now then, while that dries, another thing I need to get the hairdryer on is these. Media check. Oh, it swallowed backwards. Great. So these are part of his gun connectors. I'm just going to make sure I've got them the right way up. Unless it connects that way, is it that way? Yeah, so it's that way. He can just stand over there for a minute. Turn this up to a hotter temperature. Use this to prevent them from going zoomies. Okay, so I apologise for the hairdryer noises again. Unless one goes zoomies. I had hoped that the snips would be heavy enough to prevent that. Let's get all the bits that might be vulnerable to getting blown away away. Get them well out of getting blown range. Let's do these one at a time then. So, here we go guys, wish me luck. So if you're wondering why we do this, it's to make the resin pliable. Because otherwise, unfortunately, it will just break. Like that for a minute, and then once it's cooled I'll do it again and bend it again. This is all to stop it cracking. See, look, it is bending nicely. that's where we want it to be, then I need to twist that end. I've just remembered I removed the camera to a certain point, so I'm outside of my range again. I apologise, people.
It happens though, doesn't it? Yeah, I'm fiddling with small bits like this.
Here we go again, folks. Grief, he's getting caught on everything now. Really? Just as we're in the process of fixing you. His arm came off. It's just typical. Absolutely flipping typical. Did I not put enough glue on him or something? He was feeling armless. That's terrible. At least he's not legless. For crying out loud. These jokes, people. Come on, we can do better than this. So now we can't work on the Moritat because we have to wait for the glue to dry. Now you can see the difference between the heated one and the original cast. If I put them in camera, there we go. So we've got that one to semi-shape. We were just about to twist that when he decided to fall out of my hands. And that one is still as was cast, so there we go. Hey, some days. Not paid enough to use my corniest jokes yet. Ojin, you're not gonna get paid. Let's put the Moritat to one side for a minute so we can glue. honestly, I am not even reading that joke out. So we can now see what's going on here. When it's in camera. Alright. Alright, so now we need to find where to put his gun and his now finished dagger. Who threw that one up? Ugh, trying to see past me specs. Alright. Really? Witcher Quest is going to be the most abused sound effect I've got on here. Lost his manual now. Where have I put Lion's manual? No! God, come here. Absolutely not going the way I want it at all. Supposed to be next to his gun, but it doesn't really fit. Or fit there really either. Doing those bits before we do his arms. Snippy snips. supposed to have something in his hands? No. He's got his own stasis grenade, though. I thought I'd removed that sound alert. Thank you for following Cynical Reasoning. I apologise, but there is a small time delay on new followers. You can thank the spam bots for that. They've come in and ruined it for everyone. Always at the worst moment. Has anyone ever noticed that? Itchy nose syndrome.
Yeah. Picks his tongue very well.
It's always when you, yeah, that's what I mean. By, you know, the worst timing, I mean, you're always in the middle of something critical, you know, really, really critical, and it goes, nope, we're going to have an itch now. I'm in camera, yep. The light's still holding out just. Despite the fact I completely forgot to charge my kit. Got another piece of Lionel's arm there. Brush primer. Dab it on, let it do its thing. And I'll be able to glue those once they're dry. Speaking of dry, so I'll check on our Mr. Moritat. Doing that when he slipped out of my hands and his arm came off, which was very annoying. Still that end we need to deal with. Okay, so he can now go stand over there. We'll put this in the clippers again. We'll move the wet palette. We shall bring out the hairdryer. So incoming hairdryer noises again. So that's just become very pliable. Now we wait for it to dry. Or rather, wait for it to cool down in a way we want it to. Don't you dare, you stay there, Mr. Arm. Right, just gonna give that a gentle twist. And a quick trim here. Actually it fits into its socket. My own fingers. A little bit more heaty again because it's warped out of shape. What we'll do is we'll let him dry for the day. I will try and work on him a bit off stream to get that actually as pliable as I want it to be. I've got too many other things here that need my full attention. So let's get Lionel finished. Right then. Shoulder goes what side? So that one this side, that one that side. Right, all very important details. So I'm going to assume his arm needs to go in first then, so I think that's the arm to this one. Why is this pin not going where it's supposed to now all of a sudden? Go on, in. This is so my fingers don't have to be stuck to him. Just put that over there to dry so I don't have glue fumes up my nostrils. Where's the seat of this one? Oh, right, yep. Let's get rid of the fleck first. My red clippers. Where did I put my red clippers? Over there, right. Try foil. Foil for what? And with the itchy nose syndrome. Come on, getting you. This is where he doesn't want to put his groove in to his socket. Still no answer to what that tinfoil was about. We'll deal with your dagger after we put your arm on. Get off. Tells me he used too much glue. Yeah, we'll put his sword there instead. His arm's dry now. Ah, yes, grenades. Let's work out where to put his grenades. Have we got a 360 of him somewhere? Still. Pretty sure they used to have one of him. So I'm just looking up a reference picture while trying to peer around my own camera to see what I'm doing. Lionel Johnson. Too many people explaining his lore and not enough people showing him pictures. I'm just looking for a good spot to put his grenades, because if I touch him too much right now, he is going to fall apart. Yeah, send that one to me. That's the one I used to have before they changed their website. I believe I'm still on Discord. Cricked neck from sleep, so still looking reference pictures up. Let's see if I can get this on stream so people can see what I'm seeing. Give me a moment while I move everything so I can see what I'm seeing. I don't remember what it was called to do this. I think it's window capture. So that's who we're painting.
Grenades go on the marine that's walking up.
He's already got grenades. So I'm trying to find the rotary picture, which isn't that one.
One,
two, three, four. That's that one for me. So here we are, this is what we're, who we're painting. I've decided to go a little more flashy. But they used to have him on his entire diorama base as a rotational, and they've only part painted this. They've sort of gone, oh no, let's just paint it all white, which is a bit cheap really, because he's got wings down there that are actually red and a sword and all this other stuff that needs to stand out that just doesn't stand out when you paint it white. Plus I think from the looking of that design, it might actually be an older design, unless, because the wings I have on ours don't have that all the way down. So you can see where his gun was supposed to be and where his sword was has gone. Alright, but unfortunately for me, that did not want to stay up there, it kept falling down. So we've put the sword here, sorry, his gun here and his sword here. They've also done him grey. He's actually supposed to be a dark green. He is a dark angel. Not an Imperial Guard. I can't really see where they'd want you to put the grenades, so we'll just shove them all over his base on the floor then. Seems the most logical step. Let's find the glue again. One on his base, let me go over there to dry. Got two here that need homes now, so we'll put them on here for... Now watch me glue myself together. Come on, give me that grenade. Give me his empty hand. Nah, right, we'll see if we can glue it on his back. not to his backpack. Yes, yeah, so we've got a couple on the diorama, one on his base, and one glued to a marine. The grenades now have homes. So back to Lionel Johnson himself. So this arm is part of that arm, right. So glad Auto Mod caught that and you lot don't have to see it. Pineapples of Doom. Yeah, I suppose the round ones are anyway. The other ones, I don't know, they're kind of cylinder shaped. Wondering if I should glue that to his arm actually, but then I'm worried that his arm and his swords won't fit if I do that. So which direction is it going to be? So it's kind of like that. Okay. Wish me luck getting this right, people. And while he's still, because the next bit is his sword, we'll get finish off his gold bit. Very difficult to do well before it was glued together. Oh, I see my light's gone at last. Thought it might. It lasted longer than I thought it would. No. What is going on with this gold paint? It's clumpalizing. Notice that's still up, excuse me. What did my chat just do? Oi. There. My chat now has a forever home. Well, until I'm gaming home, anyway. Start doing all the final touches to him now before we finally glue that sword on. And that's why I don't use the painting handle. Pop that in there a minute and see if we can get him to actually asphyxiate into it. Idea being so I can handle him a little less. Going to be fun. Nope, alright, so we'll do this a different way. Still didn't go to plan. Don't know how much longer this light's going to last, but it's really not great for what I'm doing at the moment. No, you don't. The only problem I have with the Citadel handles. Citadel, you've made them ridiculously top heavy. Fix that, please, because it's damaging to models when they topple. damaging to everything else they land on too. Perhaps we as people that paint Citadel miniatures ought to start saying, well, you know what? Maybe we should start asking for refunds whenever you start giving us tat. Or not properly thinking out your designs. Pretty sure you'd start to buck up your ideas a little bit then, Games Workshop. Or flip out of their stance. Yes, that's another one they do. You saw it, the stand earlier. It's the one with the little crocodile clips on it. This is its official stand. And while yes, it does offer some stability, these things have been known, and mine has done a couple of times, come out of its stand. So, you know, a few design fixtures there, Games Workshop, for you to have a good think about. How can you deliver some quality to your customers for a change, instead of just overpriced stuff that's cheaper in most other ranges? The only thing we're paying for is the pain of fixing your stuff because you can't be bothered to quality check. Despite all my best efforts, he still managed to accumulate dust on his cloak. Time for some horrible garish green lines, which will then be painted, well, rather washed down again in a minute with some more green. Dark Angels green specifically. Horrible Asda green. Ugh. As I know, it's opal mocha green. No, this is goblin green. Opal mocha's a bit darker. This is glow in the dark green. Radioactive vomit green is another one I'd call it. Once this green is dry, I will be painting over in Dark Angel's green, which will darken this green significantly, but leave it just pale enough to add some contrast to the cloak. So by the time this cloak's done, hopefully it should look like one of those dark green cloaks of Mirkwood from Lord of the Rings. I can't look at links at the moment, Kilo, on the grounds that I have to come out of everything I'm doing to go and look at them, because I didn't have time to fully set up today. So we're going to let this horrible radioactive green dry, and then we'll wash him down and we'll get some decent contrast on him, hopefully. I really do not like this bright green, but it's a necessary evil. Don't hate it as much as pink, though. I despise pink. Oh, something else on him I spotted that I needed to paint. So it wasn't on these guys. Those to a later date. There it is, found it. Right, you can go over there and be out of the way. Remember, I pulled the silver out for a reason. There's a chain I missed. Oh, good grief. This is worse than the gold. Yeah, just DM it on Discord. I'll have a look later when I'm done streaming in a bit. I'm running a little bit later today just to do a couple of catch-up hours. Just a few highlights here and there. Still have the consistency of clotted cream, I wonder. It's getting better. I'll probably have to run it through a filter, get the clumps out of there. Right, so wet palette's coming back over. Put that there for now. That bit's done. So it's just lying on himself now. If he stops sending everything flying, that would be helpful. I can get this where I can see it. They've done the Dark Angel's Reaper in Asian colours, so they've done them in white, which means the absence of colour. Which in a lot of Asian countries, not all, but a lot, the absence of colour is death. Whereas opposed to here in the West, the oversaturation of colour, which is black, is death. Funny how we're completely yin-yang opposites in that, isn't it? So yeah, a continued reminder of throughout the stream, this is in aid of Elm Wildlife Rescue. So if you can donate to them, please follow the donate links, which there's a QR code on the video. There should be a link that occasionally pops up in chat being shouted by Botrix Official occasionally. The links are in the about panels if you're watching on one of the streaming platforms, and if you're post watching on YouTube, the link will be in the description below. It is a GoFundMe link. It can be found on the Lone Wolf All in One link as one of our top things for the fundraisers we're running. I stream on Saturday, Sunday, Wednesday and Friday. Wednesdays are our painting day. Friday we have Fright Night Fridays from 8 p.m. And Saturday is the gaming challenge, where I try to complete one game at the moment. That is Witcher 3 to be specific. And Sunday is random games night, where it might be a multiplayer, it might be a solo player, it might just be random. And so Friday, Saturday and Sunday all start at 8 p.m. UK time, with Wednesday being the exception, where I start around 2 o'clock UK time. The only exceptions to this rule is because of weather, real life drama, or for some reason I can't connect to the internet, or some other real life drama is going on in the background that requires that I give it my undivided attention for whatever reason. As will be the case this Sunday, which is the 25th of February, I won't be around because I've got some RL stuff that I really, really need to do, hopefully, assuming weather doesn't get me stuck here. But I will be back on the Wednesday as usual. And to keep ahead of what may or may not be going on, I would strongly recommend you keep an eye on our Discord announcements, our Facebook page, group, and our Twitter / X announcements. Also check out my Twitch schedule, as I try to keep that as up to date as possible as well. normal oil. Did I put Dark Angel's black in? Horrible jobs brush. There's wash brush. Although I know it might need a bigger one, but we'll see. Get a bigger one. Get it blending in. We'll do it this way then. Somehow, the wash is too thick. Now it's too thin. There's no winning, is there? Dry brush. Probably have to do this in a few layers, I think. A. I removed the Christmas songs from the playlist. Why are they back? See that do what does after it dries. Because they couldn't get me this Christmas with them, because I stayed away from places that played them, they're going to torment me in February instead. Internet, you're mean. I mean, I know the red, the gold, and the green are kind of Christmassy, but wow. Wow. Christmas songs in February. So I now need Seraphine Sepia. And a very small wash brush if I don't end up wearing the wash again.
There's more there.
Where else did it get? So I seem to be very good at wearing the washes at the moment. Now let's hope his arms go where they're supposed to. Little bit of fleck to get rid of. Just get rid of those air bubbles, it'll be great. And with that there, we shall leave him to dry. So let's bring him up to the camera. If I can get him in the camera shot. Shall take that light off. There we go. So now we're just going to let his glue dry, and I will release shots of him later on our Discord in our miniature section, where the fully finished one will finally be able to be seen. I can even remember where I put his face now. It's not exactly an easy thing to lose. But we have finally, for the most part, except for a few little things that I'm going to have to fix here and there, just to remove the excess glue and a grenade that just popped off. Lionel is done. As soon as his glue's dried and crystallized, I will give it a quick green wash and get rid of the horrible colour of dried glue. And then we should put some photos of him up and done. But he is finally done, complete with his diorama. So we're going to put him in the corner now to go dry, and I will finish him off stream, because that's all going to take about 2 minutes, but the glue itself is going to take about 5 to decide what it's going to do. So I'm just going to put those brushes in there. The Moritat, I'll do a little bit off stream with him to fix these things, and we will start painting him next Wednesday, and probably along with some other Dark Angels I desperately need to catch up on. So let's put him safely back in his box so that he's all in one place. I'll come back to him. So yep, that's just a few finishing touches and a grenade to glue back onto his base. I may as well do that while I've got him on base and I've got the glue and the snips. Put a dab of glue just there. Come on. Oh wow, that's a lot of glue. ever clean this thing. Okay. Give me that grenade. That can go over there. So I can put Lionel here. What pallet over there so I can deal with that later. Grenades at his feet now. Handle base only, Odin. I've got loads of cleaning up to do because wash is everywhere. And I will see everyone. Let me see. Let me just finger me that. Where's my outro screen? There it is. Okay, so I'm a mess. Of course the cat picked her timing, she's a cat. See? So as I was saying, I will see you, what's the day today? Wednesday. So I will see you Friday and Saturday this week. Friday night for Friday Night Frights at 8 PM and Saturday for the gaming challenge of Witcher 3. At 8 PM. So yeah, Fridays, Saturdays and Sundays at 8 PM. But this Sunday I am away. So I will see you the following Wednesday. So see you this Friday for Friday Night Frights, this Saturday for the gaming challenge, and then Wednesday for the continuation of painting and assembling Warhammer minis. So I will see you then. Have a good evening, afternoon, day, whatever time it is you are when you're seeing this. Please don't forget to donate to Elm Wildlife, which is, if I can point correctly with my finger on here, there. That QR code just there. If you're watching this on YouTube, the links will be in below, including information links, so you to check out the charity themselves, what it is they do, their YouTube link and all that stuff. So all important links will be in the description below. If you're post watching this on Twitch, again, I think the links will be in the description if that's still there. If not, they're in the about on Kick and YouTube. They are in the about panels, so please look for those panels. Please check out our other stuff, and as always, see you soon.